Thanks for joining us at 4. As we come on air, the U.S. Secret Service is under fire for its actions at the Pennsylvania rally where former President Donald Trump was nearly assassinated over the weekend. Many are calling it the worst security failure in 4 decades. Tonight, Laura Aguirre has more on the blame game that's now escalated into a formal investigation.
It was the most traumatic thing I think I've ever been through.
It's a sentiment shared by many who attended the rally Saturday where former President Donald Trump was hit and another person killed. But there's another growing concern.
I have been looking behind the stands, watching Secret Service, obviously alerted by something about a minute before.
It's those minutes before the shooting, now under increasing scrutiny.
You could see the crowd. They were alerted by something. They were like running. You could see them scattering across the lawn.
CNN has learned that snipers were stationed inside the building that the shooter scaled.
He's going down!
Witness accounts and videos show the crowd aware of the shooter on the roof nearly 2 minutes before gunfire rang out.
The time that it took to get from the bystanders who were observing it to the command post out to the agents was just too long.
No one should have ever been able to get on that rooftop.
The Secret Service says that rooftop was on a building outside of their hard perimeter, and local law enforcement was responsible for securing it. The service's director was pressed on accountability Monday night.
The buck stops with me. I am the director of the Secret Service. It was unacceptable.
I think that an investigation is necessary at this point within Congress, not just the FBI, not just others.
On Tuesday, the heads of Homeland Security, the FBI, and the Secret Service were asked by congressional House members to attend a hearing later this month to determine if there were holes in established procedure or a failure to follow proper protocol. But either way,
there needs to be accountability. And at that time, I would call for the head of the Secret Service to either resign or be removed.
I'm Laura Aguirre reporting.